relaxing from there. Okay, I turn this way, you see my hand right in front of my chest. Yeah, all right, from here, punch out. From there, right? Yeah, from just right to the elbow, punch. That's it. That's it. That's it. Aha. From the chest, push, push, push. Good. Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm. And when you hit already, when you hit it and you release it. It's like when I shoot in the punch, it just seems like I have a bow and an arrow. I pull like this. Then I let go. They snap, right? Ah, yeah. Don't try to move. Hey, don't try. The thing I keep remind you, because in karate, we always punch, we hold it. Yeah. So that will be, we want it like like that. Very good. Relaxing, snapping, relaxing, loose, loose, loose. So to practice the punch like that. Now second, after you get us good. Now second now, I'm starting, my foot starting turn. Turn. Ah, so we're starting turn together. Yes. All right. So what you think in your mind right now is the energy, our force, it starts from the floor. From the floor, go up to your knee, push your hip. Your hip pushing your elbow, right? So they go from the line from ankle, knee, hip, push, and then we punch. Ah, then now you get the whole body there. You get the whole body. Good. And keep an eye on your back hand so they don't drop. We don't drop. This is a habit we have. We're always right there. It's always right there. Good. That's it. Good. And then we'll practice that now. Your body starting turn and punch. Very good. Punch. Punch. Okay. Good. Yes. Good. All right, next. Now you're thinking of the target. There are three targets we are aiming the punch for. Number one, definitely, okay, will be around the face level. High punch to the face. Okay. Middle punch, shoulder flex area. Shoulder flex area. Okay, shoulder flex area. We'll practice that. All right. Good. Low punch, go down to your dandy. About belly button, around there. Practice like that, low punch. Okay, yes. Now, the key is like this. If you're thinking of the line from here straight down, those three dots have to be on a straight line, okay? So when I'm punching, I go here, I don't go sideways. No, I keep that line. The first target, face. Do about five punching to the face. Sort of flex, same there, same line. Load out to sort of flex. Few punch. Down two, okay. We call dandy right here. Belly button, aim right there. Good. With your body turn. First, we just need to be go slow and fix that before you put the power. Okay. All right. So now the key. If I turn this way, okay, you be watching. Sometimes when people punch high, they tend to be like this, right? Your body do that because you punch somebody high, you be like back. That big mistake. We don't want to do this. So if I need to punch somebody high, I don't do this because if he push me, we be off balance. Okay, so I try to do, I go punch him, but not lean back. Okay? Same thing. If I punch somebody down, the low punch right here, if he wrapped your legs, yes? I see in the movie people like this. You don't punch like that because you punch right here, again, he can pull me and I can fall toward to him as well. So when you punch high and you punch low, your structure of the body maintain the same. High, medium, low. See, my body did not lean back or lean forward. Try to practice that in the punch. Yes? Careful. So we do that again. High punch. Keep the same thing. Middle punch. Same thing. And somebody wrap your leg. Low punch. Still not. I just turn, shift, and punch. That's it. I don't lean forward. There. This is how we're practicing. Yes. Okay? When you start in very stable, now go back to high punch. put some of your powers in him. Make sure they're on the same line. Middle pun, same line. Same line, middle. More power. Low punch. You wrap your legs. Good. So that we get used to that kind of thing, right? So practice the punch will be like that. Now, we talk about with your stepping. So that is stand still and punch. Now stepping. Stepping means, now he's right there, feel away. I come to him. This is the rule. You always want to be the same legs. Whatever your legs is, the first punch will be the same hand. That's the rule. Because if I step forward, I go opposite punch like this. I'm open, right? We don't want that. I want it to right. Put your right first, punch. If he hits me, that punch now, the same time that a block. So we want that. I hit with the same hand. And then I can do a few more, right? Okay, so when we practice this is, let's say I put my left, I'm gonna go left first. Okay, left leg, slide with your left first, and then you keep going. Good, he's over there. Boom, I do in the first punch or pack that same hand. And then I can punch more. This way, if I'm punched and he try to hook, that first punch in also the block, right? We want that. So develop that kind of habit. Okay, good. All right, pretty good. So you got that move. Okay, that's it. And then you can now, when you get very comfortable, now you add it in at the chain punch. Sliding, three punch. Three punch. One, two, three. One, two, three. Good. Turn back the other way. Yeah, now we have your right up front. Right legs up front. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Good. And back on the other side. So instead of punch now, Barry, you can open hand like this. Open hand. I can punch him. I can palm strike him. So the palm, when you hit to the guy, this part here. Yeah, you can aim this part. Yes? Okay. This part, palm. You can use that at the attack as well, palm. Okay, good. And if he actually blocked it, I can wrap the hand. I can wrap that hand and continue palm strike. So it's like, that's why you have this as well. Same thing with the punch, but open hand. Open hand. Open hand. Perfect. Like that. Palm strike. Anytime we with palm strike, the finger is not stiff. So compared with this, with the karate palm strike, they need everything hard. Yes, the Wing Chun only need the palm, the finger loose. I hit him with this. Yes, the finger loose because our finger could be another next weapon. If I hit him and he kind of resist my finger right now, go forward, right? Yeah. That's why in Wing Chun, we want a finger loose. In karate, different. In karate, it's super hard one blade. So they actually use that at the, okay. We actually use it just a palm. My fingers are supposed to be relaxed. Yes? There you go. So that's how we want it. The other side. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. We do this so we make sure your hand in the back, Barry, they never go all the way like this. We didn't want to go like that. Just in front of you. In front of us. In front of us. So they're fast. Left, right, pretty fast. How's that? It's good? Yep. Practice the hand like that. Good. Good. That is how my tactics always go in. Circle, forward, palm. We develop the strength like that. Perfect. Okay. Now we'll talk about, now with the kick. When we standing, you want the weight in the back and the leg in the front. So the weight distribution is in the back 55, 45 in the front. Okay? So if you face somebody, Barry, so we're practicing when you face something and you need to, we need to lift up your legs. Light, I can lift right away. Yes, Good. I can lift easily. If he kick me, because I'm light in the front, look. Very easy, right? Good. So this is the habit that we want to build in Wing Chun. We don't want to be heavy in the front. But when you're heavy in the front, you look pretty solid, but we don't want to do that. You want to be light in the front. So let's say I will stay there like this. And I will be, I have something in my hand, drinking a coffee. Some guy would angry come forward attacking. Look, he coming, I should go low kick right here to his leg. So that's why in Wing Chun, we want that. We want leg in the front. If my hand not ready, my leg can throw him the kick like this. So think about it, Barry, if he come in, the leg touch him first or his hand touch you first, which one longer? There you go. That's why in karate, they like to do kicking because that makes more sense, right? The Wing Chun also have the same idea. Your legs will be from a distance coming. I just open the car. The guy run at me and punch. My first response is this. Yeah? Yeah. So I'm not ready. Maybe I got a coffee. Hey, that's it, right? Now, go back to what the difference between we and karate kick. Karate like to kick high too, which is, no, we don't prefer that because number one, I'm not flexible anymore. Number two, I don't want him to catch in my leg. So my idea is, hey, I just give it around here. It could be a real kick, Barry. It could be the real kick. It could be a little, okay. I see something come here. He stopped. Now I put my hand up, hey. Right? So something too quick. And you think you're not even fast enough to defense yourself. Put your hands up. He come right in. Throw him a little bit of the light like this. Okay? This is our normally do like that. You can do with your heel. It doesn't matter. Karate like to go with your toes. Where you aim? Straight to the groin for me. Straight to the groin. Don't tell me he doesn't care. You don't like that already, right? Hey, out. I put your hand. Now you have time to put up your hand, perfect. But that will be, to make that one fast and go natural like this, I need you to be always in Wing Chun, have the weight in the back and light in the front. Okay? If you have heavy in the front, very solid, but that is slow. We want you like that. And don't need to be powerful. So let's say you walk to the park and you have walked to the park. Get the dog, walk to the park, go to some of the little bit of the light tree, do like a little exercise. Just like, okay, it come in time, but I don't need the superpower to kick and fly in the bag. We don't need that. This one likely just around here to his leg or to his groin area, make him stop. Now I put my hands up, right? So that's how idea of Wing Chun. Wing Chun do like that, okay? Or maybe he block, I'm blocked, and then I low kick him. That's all, how fast we kick. The Wing Chun kick doesn't mean breaking, they mean to stop him. They mean to, Bruce Lee is using the word say intercept. You can say that. So at light, if he kick me, I'm light. I can put my heel to stop his leg. That's all I wanted, Barry. I use this, right? So practice the kick like that. The one that we actually have a power is the back. The back actually has a lot of power, but it's slow. The front, not much power, but they have speed.
Yeah,
speed. I can quickly stop him. So to practice in the Wing Chun prefer the back legs. They prefer the back at the stop, at the attack. Yeah, the front, and I'm coming, right? So if you add in, first, you add in a defense mode first, which is I'm here. I do a hand, the guy come at me, I throw the front kick. Then I break my hand forward or attack. Okay, all right. So front leg, hand forward. Your hand forward will be extending hand. Definitely you want a long weapon there. You don't want any short weapon. You want a long weapon. So the straight hand like this could be the attack with the chop to a throw. At the same time, it could be a block if he hit us, right? So I will do this and then build, chop to the throat. There you go. So you want to add that into same side, same leg, same hand. You want that, that, yes. Even he tried to do something from here to you, you throw the kick and you put your arm up like that, right? Put your arm up like that. So even he do this, let's say he actually come close, your hand's still blocking. Get it? Yes? Yep. So this is into your reaction, no matter what, no matter what. So don't think he hooked and I will raise my hand. Raise your hand, of course I raise my hand, but I give it a little bit like a, like together. Sweep. You see your hand block? Yeah, you see your hand block? But when you throw the kick at the same time, do that with the block and the kick at the same time, then the guy will get the kick. He knows that, oh, okay, right to the leg. So that have to be your, yes. In Wing Chun, this move, it have to be like your second nature. Second nature. It's like you go to the cobra and you try to touch a head. You will see right away. It's like, that's the move. That's the move. There you go. It doesn't matter. So don't do any of the, I will wrap his hand, I will do bong sao. No, that later. After this, and if he come close, now both our hand, we ready to bong, lap, whatever, right? But the first one from the distance, self-defense. I want this, and I want this. Continue with the straight line, okay? Because that berry, this mean block, this mean chop to the throat, yeah? Yep. This could be mean a palm strike to the face, the same family. You can use a palm to attack. It's also meaning to be a finger to his eyes. If in case with emergency, I go in, somehow he go wrap my neck. That right there. I don't want nobody wrap my neck. So as soon as I wrap, right here. Very. So that's the same move. That's why this technique is kind of a little very dangerous for people thinking about this. We don't need to be strong. I mean, back to the time when karate, kung fu guy, remember this one? Finger push up. Well, that one you actually really use it as a weapon. Okay. No. We don't need to do that. Whatever you're natural, you just a little bit loose like this. Even this. My sinful word, he said, even to go to the guy, I need a little bit of touch. Touch to a fake with a finger, right? Just like that. It's already feel like very, you know, it could be to the eye, it could be, we don't need it, okay? Woman will use that at the nail, right? At the nail, okay, nobody like that, trust me. But rather if somebody do this to you, you don't like that, definitely you want to block. Yeah, that's some move we need to get out, yeah? That's it. You don't need to actually this, it's actually at the weapon. In karate, some, you shoot, yeah, that too extreme, we don't need that. Our idea is block, I can chop. The chop to the throat, it's not hurt my hand. Emergency, I can use a finger to a little bit like that. Or just a little bit to the eye, flick to the eyes. This is all the part of, you know, the reaction, right? So build that together. Yeah, build that together. I go, man, he come in, he attack me, I'm blocked same time, I bring my legs out. Low kick, somewhere about the knee area. The lower the better, okay, he cannot catch it, right? That's annoying, kick the leg, right? Yeah, somewhere there. The maximum, a funny thing. But we learned tournament, back to the day, they said, kick the guy from the waist up. And then you kick me long here, you're out, right?
Yeah.
Kick below the belt, you're out, disqualified. Now in Wing Chun say, kick the guy below the belt, you're good. Kick behind the belt, you're out. So, you know what I mean. The dirty kick that nobody can catch it and it always hit it below the belt. Got it? So, so that while the kick go, yes. So same thing, as an unblock and I raise that hand up, immediately, his reaction is he will stop his intention, attack, or aggressive. I got this. He back out right away, right? Even he rob you, but he see your hand like this, he will back it up. Number one, we want to do that. And that will be your everyday exercise. like. Now the back legs from here, very fun. The back kick now really is that really is a break. This is now we talk about use my heel. I use my heel now and I push, right? Yeah. This is really for the power. That's really for the power. Okay. But again, in Wing Chun is not quick lightly. I do this. I feel I go to a couple up here. When we're about to finish, elbow come in. Yes. Our weapon is an elbow. Okay. I can do your back kick to storm on it. Push on it. The back. I can do my knee to actually knee his leg. Knee it behind his knee it to his leg. Yeah. So this is when I really want to use the power. That's what we need, right? Other than that, hand just need to be fast, simple, fast and flow. Idea of Wing Chun, a reaction. So go back to the thing that we learned. The reaction for the hook punch attack, you have a feel. If he closed, then you actually turn the block into the shield like this, like a tan, right? Yeah, you have two ways, a tan. Yeah, if he closed, tan and hit. Some, if a little bit further more, then the tan turn to that angle, become tan like this, further, then you can see what you just do like this. I can do this to him as well, right? Ah, so when I hit at you, you have one way, a palm tan, or you can have like a view and punch me at the same time. Same thing before. Straight the hand like this and punch that for that as well. Okay, perfect. Now learn in Wing Chun different than karate. This is they don't just go beginner go with one attack. When you go to a blue belt and come with the thing with two attack, they Wing Chun say no. Don't wait until you get blue belt. No. Right away. That's the difference. So they don't go to, I remember we learned that kumite, right? It's that called kumite in karate. First one is, and same with taekwondo. Huh, huh, huh. Only one punch and you do whatever you want. Back to a little while, then they start seeing, huh, huh, maybe two attack. Right? Yeah. No. Wing Chun don't do that. It doesn't matter, you're beginning. As soon as you get the basic, you have to do with this. Okay, none of the guy punch you like that. So the technique now is when you learn that the guy hook, you do one hand from that side, and immediately another hook coming. So you have to do, I have to be ready to be shoot at another side, both side, left, right. So when I throw in the hook, you do one, right? And then immediately the other side. And now you can punch me. There you go. You have to learn like that. Never think the guy hit you one unless he's drunk. Unless he drunk, right? But don't train like that. Then he ate more. One, two. Tan, tan. Good. And if you better, even the first one throwing that with the kick. So they actually get a kick. Then the second one never come. Even he try. Barry. If you don't kick, you still almost, you see more. Because he's still there first. You get one punch, then you try one, right? But if you do the first one with the kick, coming with the kick, boom. Now, even the second one he wanted, he moved back a few steps. It's never happened. Never be successfully come close to me because the first one, second one, yeah. So we have to build the reaction like that. Not just one, two. At least two. So that's for a time. Okay, good. Now, same thing. When the attack come with the low, what technique you do? Remember the ganda? Ganda. Go, yeah, good. Now, the one you do is good, but it lacking on body turn because you need the body turn. Yes, of course. If you want to stay there and go down, then you're gonna be black belt karate because we take so hard. But if you know, I turn my body. So the impact, that's it. The impact right now is to your hip, then you get less hurt, right? We need that, yeah. So when I do this, you gotta pivot it and get that. Good. So look at the technique like this. Move. Good. So when I go here, you do a move, boom, and then punch it, boom, 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 three punch, like that. Good. Let's say the guy just hit one, he stopped, ganda, attack him right away. Then now the guy hit two, both side, one, this side, the other side. So when you train, you're gonna watch for this. One, two. Then you do both. Uh-huh. No, if he both side very, I do this, this right away. This, this right away. And then I punch later on. But the first one, and then, yes, yes, yes. Second one, Barry? No, second one, you know, step. Look, the first, when you step, you have second slow. Look, first, second. First, turn, just turn. Yes, there you go. You know when Chang tried to save every second? Because we're not fast. You want to save, right? Right? The guy who fast, Bruce Lee don't need to save any second because he need to, he have 8 hour training. He don't need to save. We don't, we slow. Then the only thing we fast is save time on any move. No step if we don't need. So the first one you turn, second one to turn again. There you go. Look, I do this and this. I'm not even step. I just shift and shift, just like that. But again, shift, shift. How's that? Is that better? Is that better? Just right and left. Completely no stepping. No stepping. So if the guy in front of us and do this, you just pivot your hip and turn your hip. There you go. There you go. So that technique becomes like this. Here and switch hand. There, when you do that in the air. Your hip have to do the turn. Your hip have to do the turn. Yes? Right. Yes. So let's say you pick, you put your legs up. Let's say you have your right legs up, do the first turn. Okay, first turn and a second one, just turn. So nothing to do with the step, just turn, turn. They completely just the hip and the hip. This is the only way that you're fast because when I do this, see they here, I didn't step. So I'm swing, then I swing. See, I didn't step. So in order for you to be fast like me in the attack, you have to just turn. If you step, you're going to be slower than my attack, isn't it? Yes? Notice that. Good. Good. Yes. Go back to the, look at the way when I'm attacking you. I'm attacking you high and low. Look, I did not step, so my hand go fast. Same thing. You shouldn't step. You just raise your hand, block the high. With the punch, with the punch, with the punch. Tanda, with the punch. With the punch, tap, yes, and then low with the turn. That's it. You see, you have to be matching my timing. I did not step. So if you have to be step and deal with that block, you are very slow, right? So right now you deal with the heat in front of me, right to not too far, and he swing. And he swing again. That's it. You want that too, and then punch him, boom, 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 or punch or whatever. Try again, here, and there. Good, and then now palm strike, quick, boom, 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 whatever. Three punch, that's it. Again, yeah, one, two, poof, and then go. Yeah, it's good. Try again, one, two, aha, then boom, that's it. You see how it is, yeah? Go, that, and this. Yeah, and low hold, good, that's it. And then boom, three punch, maybe three punch. All right, now go back. In Wing Chun, Barry, this move, block, three punch. Okay, it's not end the game. It's not in karate. We always say one hit, one kill. Remember, you remember that one saying?
Yeah.
One hit, one kill. Wing Chun don't believe that because we don't have the strength to hit the guy and kill unless we do that. So no. Wing Chun said, no, one hit, one kill never happened for us. We're too old. We have to go in and give him the elbow to finish, right? So yeah. Our techniques always end with something like that. Not yet. He is now. He's going to be okay. He will give up. So at the elbow at your last sequence. Always at the elbow at your last thing. That means finish, right? There you go. There you go. That at least that land to the temple of the neck. Now he will give up, right?
Yep.
Unless you do another chopping the brick for a few years. Then you think one hit, one kill, like that master. No, that's not the. So we have to do more work. All right, but first is like that. Okay, now, so you notice when I'm attacking, you're not move. In the close range, you just react. Do that again. And react. That's it. And then punch, 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 punch. And end with the elbow. Any elbow that you prefer. Good. Just like that. Just like that. All right, same thing. Again. Again. Low, boom, few punching, end with an elbow, perfect. Yes, always add it in. Why Wing Chun need to do so many hit? Some people say, okay, you know what? In karate, it's one punch and the guy on the floor. Yeah, I know. We used to do that when we're younger, right? But again, the slow, the strength wasn't there. You need more. You need more. Okay, so Mike Sewell said, here's a hammer, here's a nail. Before we always aim, whoop! You hit the nail with one hammer, done. Now we need to hit a few more. Make sure we don't miss the nail, right? We hit first, and then a bit low. We still get it there. We just need to be get three strikes, right? Young guy will be, okay, one, I get it there. But if they missed it, oh, I'm sorry, I missed it. Yeah, we can't miss it. We miss it when we're in trouble. So I better nail. Okay, the nail move. Oh, I'm sure it's good. Last thing, I will get it all the way down. So Wing Chun learn to be more careful that way, right? Don't throw everything in and I miss. Don't do that. Because it overcommitted. I don't know. I hit lucky he's down. I miss it. I'm totally open. That's why Wing Chun don't like that. All right. So that is. So now you have an elbow. Top of bong like that. If your hand up ready, then whatever you do so far is great. Right? Because my hand up, I can do whatever I wanted. But now we're talking about hand down. This is more reality variable. If something happened, you walk to the guy, I don't think you like, you don't be like this first, because number one, people around say, oh, Barry put your hands up. He must be a karate guy, right? Right away, I don't know if you win or you lose, but you, when thing happened, is, oh, he put the hands up. We don't want that. My Sibu said, we are Wing Chun. We're supposed to let the guy put the hands up, you know? And when he raised a hand, he on the floor, so nobody blame us. That's true. He said, think about it. Don't put anything up. So that's why they lead to the technique called bong lakta. Your hand not up. You just flick the elbow. Because he gonna punch. But if I put my hand up front, we have a different technique. The bong lakta using when you are completely in front of him, keep the distance, and he throw the punch, my thing is respond with my elbow flick. Flick the elbow. Now take his hand. Back strike back. Okay, that we call back strike. More formally will be block, wrap his hand, and chop him to the throat. Okay, then we have this technique. Block, catch it, chop him to the throat. Okay, that is, and that's why when Bruce Lee that become a back fist, right? Okay, but that same thing. Block, take hand, chop to the throat. Okay, bong, facts out, good. Bong, take hand, chop to the throat, that's it. If he blocked my hand there, then again, I wrap this hand, I punch him with the second hand, so you can have connect to another technique. That's why we prefer attacking with open hand. We prefer open hand. When you open hand, you can do more job. You can change it. I do this, I chop, and if the guy block my chop, Barry, my hand now can wrap. Yeah, very convenient. Now I can punch him. Good. There you go. Same technique. Go back to that block again when he attacked. Block. But now when you wrap it, and then you punch, call bong like that. Okay? But when you punch, it's mean because you're pretty sure the punch will hit him. That's it. So I don't need to be catch his hand. Grab, punch, few more punch, elbow. Just like that. Does that make sense? But this is used to be practiced like that. Well, practice when you are not put your hand up. Okay? The technique not good. If I already put my hand up and the guy coming, Barry, I'm not going to use that technique. No. I put my hand up, the guy coming, I will do tanda. I will do pakda. Anything hand, just go forward, it's faster, right? This technique practice when you hand down. I just walk by and somebody throw me the punch to the face. I am blocked and I'm attack you. This is what the technique for, right? So this is called a defensive technique. Meaning you don't know what happened and it just come right to your face. And you're, you do this, right? Yes, because if we thinking of, if the punch come and I have to now raise my hand up and so hit it, it's too slow. It was like that motion, it's too slow. But if right here, I just turn away at the punch coming, and then I take advantage of that, take the hand, and hit him, so they go like little circle of motion, they're faster, right? Ah, there you go. The best for that technique. How's that, Barry? Yes?
Great.
Work on that. This is a drill. You have to be like it, like exercise.